Hey guys! A couple of months ago, I refilled these two desiccated jars. They were jars that previously housed aquatic ecosystems. The smaller jar was filled with pond water and sediment, as well as aquarium plants and all kinds of critters. The larger jar was also home to some pond critters, as well as aquarium plants, cherry shrimp, and even mosquito larvae. I then let the water evaporate, and over the course of a few years, the jars and everything in it dried out completely. After a day, the large jar got a bit of a tint. In the small jar, life already re-emerged after a day, in the form of bacteria. So, it revived! A success! The bigger jar, however, only showed the skeletal remains of diatoms, and no living things. After 9 days, both jars got cloudy, and the smaller jar developed a biofilm, consisting of a dense soup of bacteria, and even more life reappeared. Different ciliates and flagellates. Look at that! The re-emergence of life in a completely desiccated ecosystem after a little over a week. The larger jar also has a thin biofilm, meaning that life re-emerged in the larger ecosystem as well, after 9 days. And, if we take a bit of a closer look, we can actually see this life, flagellates and bacteria. After about 2 weeks, the water in the small jar had gotten really dark, and the biofilm very thick. The biofilm was by now partly composed of stringed bacterial colonies. There was also a new microbe present, Lacrimaria. It was clear that after 2 weeks, life in the bigger jar was also booming. Just look at this large ciliate. These tiny microbes, cryptomonas, which are single-celled flagellate algae, are the ones responsible for turning the water yellow, and they're obviously very abundant. After about a month, the jars looked like this. The smaller jar was almost pitch black. Due to evaporation, I had to add some water again. The stirring of the water column resulted in the water being lighter a day later. In the large jar, algae mats were starting to grow on the glass. Let's take a look at what the microbial community looks like after a month. So that was the first month. If you saw the previous video about this project, you saw everything up until this point. That video is way more detailed though, if you're interested. But what happened since then? Let's find out! 6 days after you last saw these jars, they looked like this. The water in the small jar got clearer and the large jar was greener. The large algal mat was now floating again. You might have noticed that it can't really decide whether to float or sink, and you can actually see this in real time as well. This is a clip from 2 weeks later. It's hard to say why this happens. At first I thought it probably gained buoyancy due to oxygen bubbles formed by algae in or below the mat. But then why would it start sinking again, even though we didn't see any bubbles come up? And sometimes it floats all the way up to the surface and stays there for a while, or stays in the middle of the water column, like we saw 2 weeks ago. It seems we have a little bit of a mystery on our hands. It does seem to be oscillating, in smaller time frames and motions like you just saw, but also in larger ones. Oh well. A lot of algae is growing in both jars, on the glass and in the water, but also on the water surface. Something's brewing. This is what the jars look like just a few days before they turn 2 months since rehydrating. The oscillating algal mat, hey, that's a cool band name, or is it? Anyway, it's been scraping off some of the biofilm from the glass. And the smaller jar has a really nice color. But Wait a minute. What's that? Do I see something moving in the water? Oh yeah, baby. The ostracods have returned. Isn't that amazing? Even on such a tiny scale, small crustaceans can hatch from eggs deposited when the system was still submerged, even after years of being completely dry. There's only a handful of them in the jar, so the conditions must have been just right for a handful of eggs to hatch at the same time, as no reproduction has taken place, which can be seen by a lack of age and size difference, and the fact that there's only a couple of them. Or, and this might be more likely, one egg hatched, and I somehow missed it, which then through parthenogenetic reproduction gave rise to the ostracods we see now. Just a month later, this was the situation. I guess it's safe to say there has been a population bloom. The water is not green anymore, possibly because the ostracods ate all the algae, and they have also been munching away on the old dried algae, which is now also mostly gone. You can now also see, due to the different sizes, that there's many different ages and even generations living simultaneously. So, 3 months after being submerged again, this ecosystem is now home to thousands of crustaceans, the offspring of the sea shrimp that swam around here years ago. Just 2 days later, I saw something swimming in the big jar as well. A month after the small jar, a few dormant ostracod eggs also hatched in the larger jar. Interestingly though, a different species. They might have emerged a month later because the smaller jar has an actual sediment layer and the larger jar doesn't. But it might have also been a coincidence, or one of many other reasons, really. In this clip from the small jar a few days later, you can see how the ostracods are feasting on pieces of algae that are ancient on their timescale. Just 5 days after they appeared in the large jar, the population of the smaller species of sea shrimp exploded as well. They have a lot to eat and a lot of space to swim. Here you can see that the smaller species also likes to eat the ancient algae. So, 3 months since rehydrating completely dried out ecosystems in jars, we saw the return of bacteria, then single-celled algae and other microbes, and now even crustaceans from eggs that were able to withstand years of dry conditions. It's like having a vernal pool on a really small scale. That is really interesting, especially since the sources of the sediment and organisms in these jars are bodies of water that never dry out. So all organisms that re-emerged were capable of surviving conditions or producing eggs or cysts that could survive conditions they normally wouldn't face. Really impressive. Who knows? Maybe other species will re-emerge as well. Only time will tell. If you want to find out and haven't already, well, you're going to have to subscribe. Thanks for watching.